Hello, this is John Zammit, and welcome to another video in our series titled Exploring SNOMED CT Content. In this video, we'll demonstrate some of the search capabilities of the SNOMED CT browser. We will start by showing you how to initiate a simple search. First, we must click on the Search tab. Then click on the Search field and key in a search term. We can use words or partial words. For example, PNEU will generate search results such as pneumonia. The order of search terms you enter does not matter. For example, PNEU and VIR will generate results such as viral pneumonia. Let's try searching using another partial term, FRAC. Note that the search results are ordered, with the shortest at the top and the longest appearing at the bottom. This helps to ensure the results, which most closely match the search string you entered, will appear at the top of the list. The fully specified name associated with each search result is displayed in this column on the right. This helps to disambiguate between concepts with similar descriptions, for example, fracture the disorder versus fracture the morphologic abnormality. If we click on one of the search results, the concept details are displayed on the right-hand side of the browser. Another useful option is to enable group by concept. For example, with our previous search for viral pneumonia, we have 38 matching search results, but if we click on group by concept, the number of matching search results drops from 38 to 18. This is because the search results have now been filtered to display only one term for each concept. There are other search modes which can be useful. The default behavior is to present search results for partial matches, but you can also match on the full text or even search using regular expressions. The default behavior of the browser is to show only active components, but we can filter to show components that have been inactivated using the status options. For example, let's repeat our previous search for fracture, then enable active and inactive components. Inactive components appear in red. Here we can see the inactivated concept, fracture not otherwise specified. Hierarchy tag filtering can also be useful. For example, let's suppose we wanted to limit a search on left ankle to procedures and not display body structures, findings, or content from other hierarchies. Once we have initiated the search, we can click on the checkbox beside the semantic tag procedure, which will then filter the search results to display only procedures. We can remove a filter by unchecking the box beside the semantic tag. By clicking on the small clock icon, we can review the search history for this browser session. This can be useful if we want to go back and refine a previous search. In some cases, it can be useful to search using an identifier. In SNOMED CT, we search using SCT IDs to uniquely identify components. For example, let's use the SCT ID for disorder of lung. By pasting the identifier into the search field, we retrieve all the terms that are associated with this concept. That concludes this demonstration. In the next video, we'll explore how to view concept details. Thanks for watching, and goodbye for now.